Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Shadowwraith, and today I'm going to be talking about how to play Clan Pestilence for Skaven. I recently just played a game. Literally, I've just come out of playing a game with Clan Pestilence, and I didn't have high hopes because, I mean, Scryer is the way to go. They've got so much shooting and stuff like that. But I didn't want to cover Scryer. I wanted to cover my boys Nurgle. Okay? I'm a Nurgle man. Right? I love Nurgle. Okay? So, what you want to do, or what I did, and this is just in case you want to do, is, for your general, I'd stick it as the Plague Priest on his Plague Furnace. Absolutely. Absolutely. And the reason why is because he can pray, and you want to pray because your clan bonus is you get basically nuclear prayers. By nuclear prayers, of course, I mean Echoes of the Great Plagues. So basically how that works is if you roll a 6 when you're praying, you can pick one of the following great plagues to manifest in addition to the effect of the prayer. So fantastic. Each plague can only be manifested once per battle, and no more than one great plague can be manifested in the same turn. Now, what you've got is a bubonic blight plague. So basically what that is you pick the nearest enemy unit within 13 inches of the priest, and they take D6 mortal wounds. If you slay that unit, you can pick the next nearest unit, or another unit within 6, you get to pick, and they suffer D3 mortal wounds. If you wipe that unit out, somehow, luckily, you get to pick another unit, and it does D3 mortal wounds, and it just keeps on going and keeps on going, until there's no enemy units within 6, or the unit isn't destroyed. Awesome, that's not bad. The next one you've got is the Crimson Wheel Curse, if this Great Plague manifests, pick the nearest enemy unit within 13. The unit is infected with this curse. You can pick if there's multiple within, that are equally close, if that ever happens. The infected unit suffers one mortal wound. In addition, at the start of each hero phase, the infected unit and each enemy unit within one of the infected unit suffers one mortal wound. So they just keep taking little bits of damage, so you can pick something away, especially if you get a hero. That's fantastic. Take one mortal wound a turn. Awesome. And if you're near anything, they're going to take one too. Because you've got, something horrific. And then the other one you can pick is the Red Maw Plague. Same again, 13 inches. But you have to pick a hero. So you have to pick a hero within 13 inches. And this one's pretty nuts. Basically, if the hero's on his own and near one of its own units, within 3 of one of its own units, you can take command of that hero until the end of the combat phase. So, I mean, just think of the heroes that you could control. Archeon, Nagash, and they're yours for a turn. That is nuts. Absolutely nuts. Wow. And then the last one is the Never Plague. And basically, you can re-roll friendly clan pestilent priests for the battle. Yeah, they're prayer rolls. Awesome. And then you've got the Undulant Scourge. You pick the nearest enemy unit within 13. And you roll one dice for each model in that unit. For each 5+, it suffers a mortal wound. So that's not too good. I mean, that's not the best one. I think that's probably one of the worst ones. But it's still great. Now, going off this, we're going to go to our Warlord trait. So you've got your priest on his Plague Furnace, right? Okay. You're going to then give him the command trait, Master of Rot and Ruin. And that lets you reroll the dice that determines if a prayer chanted by this general is answered. Okay. Then you're going to pick the relic or artifact, whatever. And the one you want is, I'm going to have an attempt at saying this, the Liber Bubonicus. Yeah. Liber Bubonicus. There you go. And basically, you can pray twice. Yeah. You can pray twice in the hero phase. One from each of his prayers. And he's got two prayers. Right, so not only can you reroll it, you can now try and manifest two prayers. And bear in mind, if you roll a 6, which you have a higher chance of now because you're rerolling, you have a higher chance of getting them off anyway, you get to do one of the mega, mega plagues. With these guys, you just want to bring as many plague monks as you can. That's what I'd do. Plague monks, plague monks, plague monks, all day long. Don't get me wrong, you might get beaten up by shooty armies, but it's Age of Sigmar, so hopefully there aren't too many about unless you go against Scryer. Which I did. And I did okay. I did okay. For the prayers that this bad boy can do on his plague furnace, you get filth, filth, filth. And basically you pick one friendly can, pestilence unit, wholly within 13 of this model, and you can reroll wound rolls for the attacks made by that unit until the next hero phase. Awesome. Okay. Then you've got rabid, 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 which is basically, same again, 13 inches, wholly within, and they get one plus one attack. Okay. I'm not going to go over the stats of the plague priest and stuff like that, because I don't care about that yet. He's not meant to be in combat anyway. Who cares? Okay, who cares about that? The other best thing he does is you don't have to take battle shock tests. Okay, that's it. Hollywood 13, so that's not bad. Now, go on to the plague monks. Let's see what these guys can do. Right, you've got two weapon option choices. You can go for the fotted blade, which is 1 inch, 2 attacks, 4s to hit, 4s to wound, no rend, 1 damage. Not bad. Or you can have a woe staff, okay, and a woe and a fossil blade. Okay, that's not bad. And basically, what that gives you is an extra attack that hits on 4s, and this has got a 2-inch range, and wounds on 5s. That's okay, not too bad. Right, the way I ran this, either way, either option is very valid. Either option. Okay, I mean the best way to play this, in my opinion, is to bring them with the woe staff and the fotted blade, because that's 3 attacks and you've got a 2-inch reach, so more guys can get more attacks in. But don't look at the base stat line yet, okay? Because you can give these guys plus 1 attack with a prayer, okay? And you're rerolling to wounds, so that 4+ and 5+, cool, rerolling that. On top of that, if you roll a 6, a natural 6 for the wound roll, because you've got an icon of pestilence, you can add 1 to the damage. So now these 1 damage rubbish weapons are doing 2 damage each, which is a massive difference. On top of that, the Bale Chime, these are all things you can bring if you have, well, we're going with a squad of 40, so you can bring all of this. If you rake an unmodified hit roll of a 6, you improve the rend by 1. So then minus 1 rend, 2 damage if you roll a 6 followed by a 6, if you get that lucky. Now, if you've got the prayers on them, and you charge your plus 1 attack, so your 3 attacks with your blades, and 2 attacks with your staffs, okay? Then, if you charge your plus 1 attack again, so you're now doing 4 attacks with your blades, and 3 attacks with your staffs, and you are hitting on 3s because you've got more than 10 units. Is it 10? Yeah, 10 models in your unit. And you are wounding on plus 1 because you've got over 30 in your unit. So, you're now hitting on 3s, okay? And wounding on 3s with the blades. And you're wounding on hitting on 3s with stars and wounding on 4s. With the with stuffs, and obviously if you roll 6s you get the double damage or the minus 1 rend or both if you're lucky. Okay, on top of that, if you get the prayer off to reroll wounds, you are also rerolling the wounds. Yeah, okay. Now with these backing them up, you will want a Vermin Lord Corruptor. Okay, and I mean, don't worry about his stats, he's pretty trash in combat in my opinion. I mean, he gets 10 attacks, hit on 3s, wound on 3s, minus 1, 1 damage. If you roll a 6 to hit, you do a mortal wound and the attack sequence ends. Absolute trash. Okay, so I wouldn't worry about that. What you want to worry about is his command ability, which basically is pick one friendly model with his command ability. In that phase, you can reroll hit rolls for friendly clan pestilence units whilst they're wholly within 13 of this model. So now, going back to your plague months, they've got a bunch of attacks. What's that? Plus 2, so they're 3, plus 4. So they're 7 attacks per plague monk, okay? So the first 2 ranks, if they're all into base contact, are getting 7 attacks each, okay? And they're hitting on plus 1, so they're hitting on 3s, re-rolling because of this guy. And then they're wounding on 3/4s, re-rolling because of the prayer. And that just, I mean, that obliterates a lot of things. And this isn't including like mortal wounds that you can possibly do at the start of the hero phase with the Book of Woe and stuff like that. This is, yeah. They're pretty, yeah. And then this guy brings a bit of magic in. So you've got 2 dispels and 2 spells. But his spell is, I mean, it's okay. It casts a value of 7, which is insanely high. If successfully cast, pick an enemy unit within 13 and roll 1 dice for each model. On a 4 plus, they suffer a mortal wound. So it can be good for clearing mobs, but rolling on a set, rolling a 7, it seems quite high. For some of the spells out in Age of Sigmar that need like a 5 or a 6, is yeah. Yeah, I don't know. That's just my piece on it. On top of that, your 2 heroes, so your Plague Furnace and this guy, have a 5-up save for wounds and mortal wounds. So that's awesome. Protection of the Horned Rat. Awesome. Now, with your Plague Monks, you're going to want to bring maybe 3 squads of these to make up the battle line. Okay, 3 squads of 40. I mean, bear with me. And then I brought 2 Plague Furnaces. One of them was my Warlord, and then I gave the other one an artifact that didn't really do anything. I think I gave him the Foul Pendant. And I think I said earlier you need 10 or more models, get the plus 1 to hit. I was wrong. You need 20 models. So if you put in the comments that I'm wrong, I'm rectifying it now. You need 20 or more models to get the plus 1 to hit. So you've got that because you've got 40. And you need 30 or more models to get the plus 1 to wound, which you've got because you've got 40. Okay? And now, the battalion that I bring is the Congregation of Filth. So basically, you get a 6-up save against wounds and mortal wounds as long as you're within wholly within 18 inches of the Plague Priest, so the Plague Furnace, for your Plague Monks. Awesome. And all you need is a Plague Priest on Plague Furnace and 2 plus units of Plague Monks, which you've got because you've got 3. If you don't like that one, it's alright. This is the first initial list that I've used for him, and I think it worked really well. Okay? It's pretty solid. And, yeah, it's got some shenanigans. Some good shenanigans. Anyway, that's all I wanted to say. Thank you ever so much for listening. If you've got any comments on what I've said, or if I've got something wrong, please do let me know in the comment section below. Because I'm not a pro at Age of Sigmar. I'd still say I'm learning Age of Sigmar. Played it for a while, but hey-ho. Yeah, please let me know. Anyway, I hope you have an absolutely fantastic day, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.